We can show you these visuals coming from the police headquarters. Remember, several women's groups had come together outside the police headquarters and actually laid siege to it. So water cannons now being used to disperse the crowd. Well, you can see the action against those people protesting. They'd held a chakka jam of sorts, protesting against the gang rape in Delhi, asking for better security for women, asking that the police commissioner take action. So activists there being dispersed by the Delhi police using water cannons. All right, just to correct there, this is actually coming from outside the chief minister's residence. The activists who had gathered outside the police headquarters had said that other people would be protesting outside the chief minister's residence as well, but the police having none of it, using water cannons to ensure that the mob does not collect there and lay siege in the same way that they've done at the police headquarters. So lots of anger, lots of different women's groups really coming together. We've seen over the past 2 days protesting against the state of affairs in the national capital that led to this poor girl being gang raped in a moving bus, crossing three PCRs, crossing several police barricades. No action taken. Enough is enough is what the activists are demanding, and you can see them marching head on despite those water cannons. So a lot of anger. The police obviously trying to control the situation outside the police headquarters, which is a very, very busy area of Delhi. Hundreds of activists have laid siege there. They've blocked the roads. Well, right, Siddharth Pandey joining us on the phone line from there. Siddharth, we're seeing these visuals, the activists are trying to really block the roads outside the chief minister's residence, but the police trying to disperse them using water cannons.
Well, that's right. In fact, the main road in front of the chief minister's house in the heart of the capital actually has been blocked right now temporarily by the police. Protesters were actually trying to break through the barriers and enter the CM's house, and the police had to resort to charging, hitting them with water cannons. The crowd, of course, still in a belligerent mood, still at the gates of the CM's residence, not budging from here. And the police, of course, as I said, have blocked both the entrances to the road which actually leads to the CM's house at the moment. The chief minister is not at her residence. I checked with the staff out here, but the protesters here also think that they're going to continue to protest. The police, of course, as I said, has just hit them with water cannons. Gargi.